You want smoke?
No, thanks. I'm good.
All right. Damn. You can do that?
Yeah.
That's like really dope. Is that what you do? Are you like an artist, a comic book guy?
I wish.
Those guys make pretty good bread.
You draw?
Me? Nah. I suck at it.
You ever try?
No, you gotta be like born with that, you know?
It's like learning to write your name, you know? You write it enough times, you can write anything without even thinking about it.
Yeah, I mean, that's a bit different.
All right, check this out.
Dude, I just told you I can't draw, right?
Just try. Use your board. All right, just copy what I do. Nice and simple. Make this shape.
Yeah, okay.
Just follow the line.
Like that?
Yeah. Nice. Yeah. Now, the one just below, another shape, just like this. Nice and simple. Yeah, you got it. I'll stick some teeth on his gums. Nice. Yeah, you got it. Yeah. How about some hair?
Hair? All right. Damn. Who is this guy?
I don't even remember. I've been drawing him since I was a kid.
Shit.
It's good. It's really good. It's really good.
I can't believe I just did that.
See? You're a natural.
Yo, Jimmy!
Yeah, I'll be right there. Can I keep this?
Sure.
Yeah?
Threw it.
Yeah, I guess I did. I'll see you around though, right?
See you around.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages, today we are joined by writer and director of a brand new film being released from Lionsgate called 5 Pounds of Pressure, Phil Allocco. Phil, say hello to everybody.
Hey. Hi, everyone, and thank you so much for having me.
It's awesome to have you here. I watched the movie this morning, and I have to tell you, that was very, very suspenseful, man. Like, you had me the whole time just gripped in, ready. Let's talk about this. The movie is about a ex-con played by Luke Evans who gets out after serving quite a lengthy sentence for manslaughter. And all of the surrounding neighborhoods of Red Hook in New York City that are all at the same time simultaneously dealing with a crime spree occurring due to various characters selling drugs and doing all these other things. But at the center of this film is a man trying to do right who's been out of jail and on parole for 3 years. Can you talk to the audience about casting this cast? Because it's a wonderful cast. Luke Evans, Rory Culkin, Alex Pettifer. Even I've never really seen Rudy Pankow in anything, but he was great here. Can you talk about putting that together?
Yeah, no, I you know, we started with Luke Evans, which we're thrilled to get Luke. I mean, I feel like that sets the tone for what your film is, you know, the kind of film, the possibility we have and what we get to make. And getting him was a dream. I knew he would be amazing. I think he's great. And then getting Rory, I think he brings so much empathy to the character of Mike. Mike is, you know, on paper is not a very likable character. And I think Rory does a great job of bringing such vulnerability and empathy. And Alex is an amazing actor. I think super gifted. And I just love the whole cast, Rudy, Stephanie, Leonidas, and Savannah and Zach. I think they're all just really great actors.
How did you get them put together? Was that you, or was that, do you have a casting director helping you out there?
Yeah. I mean, you have a casting director. So, you know, I mean, it starts with the director wanting to go to someone on in the main lead. You know, like I remember seeing Rory in Lords of Chaos, and he was, I couldn't believe the what he brought to that character and the empathy he brought to a very unlikable character, like I was talking about with Mike. And I felt like he would be so great for this, you know, for Mike. And luckily he wanted to do it. I mean, I was thrilled that he would come on. And then, you know, some, you also have your casting director who gives you ideas on characters that I may not have a specific actor I already have in mind that I want to go to. And then you go through casting process. So, you know, it's a bunch of different ways that actors kind of come to you and are brought to your attention. But ultimately, I'm just thrilled with the cast that we have. I feel like, you know, I feel very fortunate that I feel like we nailed every character as far as what I was hoping for.
No, I think you did. I love that because I do see a lot of similarities between his character here and his Euronymous in Lords of Chaos. So I'm glad you brought that parallel. That was going to be something I was about to bring up myself. So I'm
oh, really?
I did it. Yeah. Yeah. Because here's the thing. In this movie, he's like this complete, like, he seems like he's probably a nice guy, but in reality, he's just a scared little boy. And Lords of Chaos, he's the exact same thing. Euronymous is a scared little boy who is too big for his britches. And I feel like Mike is the same way here. What made you want to write and direct this? Because this is you wrote the screenplay and you obviously directed your own screenplay, but where did the story come from?
I mean, I grew up with people like this in a world like this and with these kinds of issues. And I think I've always kind of struggled with understanding my own feelings about these kinds of things and knowing people who are on both sides of these actions or crimes or whatever. And I think, you know, I think it was kind of cathartic to write it. I think it was me trying to have empathy and understanding for things that are hard to understand for me.
Yeah, I completely agree. I was thinking like, there's probably got to be some semblance of autobiography for it in it for you. And so I'm glad to hear that that is exactly the case. Now, Phil, this is the first time that I've ever interviewed you. So I always ask the same two questions every guest I get. And the first one is very easy. It's just, who are some inspirations for you, whether that be professionally or personally?
Well, as a director, I mean, Paul Thomas Anderson, I love, you know, I love Kubrick, I love Scorsese, I love Woody Allen, there's so many, I could go on and on, right? But I think Darren Aronofsky is probably a big inspiration when I think of Requiem for a Dream, you know, which is also a very gritty, different kind of story, but a gritty New York story of a dark story. That's kind of a cautionary tale in a way.
I like that. So you mentioned some fantastic directors, and it's funny because we were just discussing Requiem for a Dream because we were talking about how much Aronofsky takes from the movies of Satoshi Kon. So it was funny because if you ever seen Satoshi Kon's animated films, Aronofsky's referenced them a few times in a few of his films.
Oh, really? Yeah, I'm not familiar with that. I will have to check. I will have to do that. But I do love how he, I love how he portrays darkness and finds profound meaning in these very dark subjects. I love that.
I totally agree with you. I think that's a darn good catch right there. I like that. Now, the second question is the hardest question of the day, so take your time with it. And that's, if you only had two movies to watch for the rest of your life, what two would you pick and why?
Oof, that's a tough one.
Yep.
Wow. probably 2001 Space Odyssey. I probably would always watch that one.
That was a good pick.
Yeah, I mean, how could I would probably, Annie Hall is probably another one I would always watch because I can't get over how good the writing is in that and how inventive, you know, and how many different, when you watch the film and you think of all the different techniques from animation, to, you know, there's a great scene where he's talking with Annie Hall and they're subtitling what they're really thinking. Like there's so many innovative things that are happening as a filmmaker that beyond it just being a comedy or romantic comedy, it's just beyond that.
I love that. And you picked two 70s American films. So if anybody tries to say that the 70s is not the greatest decade of American cinema, They are incorrect. It definitely is. Those are great picks. I love those. So, pressure cooker time. Give me a 30-second elevator pitch for 5 pounds of pressure.
Oh, wow. Okay. It is a story of redemption, right? You have Adam who's seeking redemption, trying to meet his son who he's never doesn't know. And at the same time, you have the younger brother of the man he killed seeking revenge. And I think, I think setting that all together, I lost myself there. How about a 3 hour pitch?
That's longer than the movie, Bill.
Yeah. A gritty story of violence and redemption. I don't know. I'm terrible at that. I failed you on that one.
Here, let me help you.
You do it for me.
From Lionsgate Films, 5 pounds of pressure, a story of a man seeking redemption and a neighborhood doing the same thing.
Love it. I think that's great.
Because here's the thing, and agree with me or not, nobody in that neighborhood, if they know what happens, has any respect for Adam at all, even though he's trying to turn his life around.
No, I think that's... Yeah, it's a thing Luke and I talked about. I thought he brought an amazing insight. You know, he was saying he would love for, Adam wherever he walks, or, that people, give him dirty looks and when you walk in those old Westerns and everyone's like closing their shutters when you walk down the block. And, I love that visual. And I think he does carry that with him, that, that nobody's going to really let him forget or forgive what he's done. And maybe no one should, and maybe he'll never forgive himself, right? But he's still seeking some sort of redemption. He's still, like he says, he could still do something good. And I think he's holding on to that and hoping he can. So I think, I think that sums up his kind of what he's hoping for.
I love that. I think you about nailed that. And I have to tell you, this one surprised me, because I went into it thinking, I don't know what this movie's about. I don't even know what this is. But then I walked away thinking that was a very, very good palate cleanse thriller, given all the stuff I've seen this week that wasn't nearly as good. So, Phil, everybody should check this out. It will be out next Friday. Is that right? March 8th?
Yeah, that's it.
In theater near you guys. Make sure you're checking it out, because... Luke Evans is on a winning streak for me. He's done 2 movies this year, and both of them have been good. That includes this one right here, 5 pounds of pressure. Phil, is there anything else you want to leave the audience with before I let you go?
Oh, well, first, thank you so much. And thank you for watching it. And I hope the audience, I hope everyone out there gets a chance to see the movie, and I hope you like it. And I hope it's a fun ride.
It certainly is a fun ride, guys. For Film Snob Reviews, obviously, this has been William, and that's been Phil Allocco. We'll see you next time, guys.